We're glad you could join us for Middle Tennessee Record. A couple of years ago, a strange object appeared on the lawn behind MTSU's Cope Administration Building. It looked like something E.T. would have built so he could phone home. Now there are 12 similar concrete rectangles with strange symbols and unusual metal shapes on top. And in an odd way, you might say they have been constructed to help us get in touch with the stars. Ashley Ball has visited the site and asked some questions. Ashley, what is it?
Well, Tom, it's MTSU's Naked Sky Observatory. Some people have called it Stone's River Henge. It's a giant sundial, a calendar, an astronomical observatory, and more. Astronomer Eric Klumpe, who conceived of this beautiful and unique learning opportunity, paid homage to the ancient Greek astronomers by calling it the Uranidrome. Urana, from the Greek word for sky, and dromos, meaning a large, specially prepared place. Now, being the fastest growing university in the state has its advantages and its disadvantages. And one of the casualties of MTSU's growth has been the telescope and observatory on the east side of campus. As the athletic fields grew up around it, the observatory became stranded in the midst of a tremendous amount of light pollution.
I'm standing next to the observatory of the telescope for Middle Tennessee State University, and this is an integral part of our astronomy program here as far as instruction. But if you can hear as well as I can, right now there's construction going on outside this building. And what's happening is the athletic facilities here at Middle Tennessee State University are being improved, but in the middle of this is the observatory. And one of the things I discovered was if I went in the observatory and opened the dome, I could read a book. I go, this is great. I can read the operator's manual. I can do all this stuff. And I go like, but I want it to be dark so I could do astronomy.
Necessity is the mother of invention, and MTSU definitely needed a new observatory. But a lucky accident can also claim some paternity in the case of the Uranidrome. Klumpe's interest in the ancient Greek astronomers caused him to view merely architectural features in a different light.
All we were talking about was a building to put in a telescope, something to replace the one that I had just shown you by the women's softball field. That's all we were thinking. And he gave me three different renderings, and he used all kinds of computer graphics. This is one of the three that he had shown me, and I actually kept a copy of the files. Here's the dome, and this is a grass berm that kind of surrounds it. And on the far side is like a little, not a tunnel, but like a little notch that's taken out, and you walk in. He's just being creative, okay? He's very creative. And he put these columns all around it. And I said, what are those for? He goes, I don't know. I just thought they looked cool. But when I looked at those columns, something in my mind clicked. I said, wouldn't it be possible if we could take those columns and use them to do astronomy? Is there a way we can kind of integrate that into the design? It was at that point this idea of a naked eye observatory was born.
We spent some time recently with Dr. Klumpe and asked him to give us a tour of the Uranidrome and demonstrate how it can be used to measure time and learn more about astronomy.
Well, telescopes are a big part of how we teach astronomy here at Middle Tennessee State University. But when we use a telescope, the intent is usually to produce a larger image, like say of a planet, so you can see the rings of Saturn or the moons of Jupiter. In the case of this Uranidrome, where we're doing mostly naked eye astronomy, we are typically monitoring the motion of the sky over the course of a few hours or over the course of many days. And where I'm standing right now is an aspect of the Uranidrome that we can use to measure the motion of the sky over the course of a few hours. And the way it is set up, we have a device on the top, a sculpture, if you will, that has a circle. And if you stand in the appropriate place here in front of me on the plaza, and the color codes are related to people's heights, people of different heights would stand at a different spot, but if you stand in the appropriate place, everybody will see the North Star dead center in that circle. And those radial bars that move outward from the center of that circle now form a grid onto the background of stars, because something that makes the North Star unique as compared to all the other stars in the sky is it is the only star that appears in the exact same place all night long, every night of the year. So it serves as a reference point, a point about which all the stars seem to rotate. I'm standing in the center of the plaza of the Uranidrome, and from this perspective, the Neptune column, which is in front of me, is due west. To my right is the Uranus column, and then to my left is the Pluto column. If I were to monitor where the sun were to set every day of the year, I would note that on the equinoxes, okay, which would be the first day of spring and the first day of autumn, the sun will set directly behind the center of the Neptune column. However, on the solstices, which would correspond to the longest day of the year or the shortest day of the year, or sometimes referred to as the first day of summer or the first day of winter, the sun will set behind the Uranus column on the first day of summer, and it would set behind the Pluto column on the first day of winter. These columns then represent the range at which I could see the sun setting over the course of a year. This is a smaller sundial that a lot of people have in their yards. They're a lot of fun, and they're actually pretty accurate. We've taken this concept to a much larger scale. This plaza in the Uranidrome here is going to become one huge sundial, and we're going to use shadows not from a little small piece of metal like this, but a very large piece of metal, which is behind the camera right now. And it casts a shadow, and we can see that shadow right over here. Right here is the shadow of a large ball. And this shadow, once we have this concrete calibrated in the same way that that sundial over there has little numbers, we need to put numbers on our concrete, and we'll be able to tell time using the sun with the Uranidrome sundial. One of the things I would like to do is indicate where the shadow is right now. I found this piece of wood just off on the side there. It's just a piece of debris. What I'm going to do is I'm going to place it in such a way that it'll point to where the shadow is right now. I'm going to lay it down just like this, and as you can see, it sort of points. Originally, the shadow would have been a circle right about here, but now, note, I'll keep my left hand there. It's moved all over to here. That's not quite a meter, but very close to a meter in just a matter of 25 minutes.
Though it's fairly new to campus, it's easy to see that people are already drawn to this unique set of structures. It's a place to come sit, stand, walk, and stare. And most importantly, the Uranidrome is a place that helps us understand the vital and fascinating relationship between ourselves and the heavens.